I'll just show you a demonstration. It's like you go like this. Okay. So, say first you move one. I'm showing a little fast, a little slow. First, the coordination will go because you won't know what to do. Eventually, as your brain starts functioning, the coordination will come automatically. So, like, do like 2 to 3 times. Don't do 5, but 3 breaths each till you get a little bit coordination so that the next exercise will be easy for you. So, practice it for 5-10 minutes.
Okay.
Go at your pace. Once you feel, sometimes the problem occurs that once you do this, and then you do. So once you start from the left, inhale from the right, inhale from the left and exhale from the right, that time you go to the next exercise. So one cycle is,
okay.
Then you can leave and go.
Okay.
So like that you count. Left to right, right to left is one. So like this when you do 5. So when you start the inhale from the left and when you drop the exhale from the right, that time you can leave and go to the next exercise. So flow happens. So. When you do it slow, fast coordination won't come. Okay, you go very slow. Because even if you do this exercise 4 in coordination, this 4 exercises, more than enough. The amazing exercises will improve your glands, hormones, everything.
Okay.
Just these 4 exercises. No need to do any exercise. Even if this exercise can go for hours, because it will slowly, you will see, you will go into trance. If you are really meditating well, just concentrate on, once everything falls into place, just concentrate on the heartbeat.
Mm-hmm.
Now there are too many things to think, inhale, exhale, so it is becoming confusing.
Mm-hmm.
As you do again and again, it will become seamless. You won't have to think about it. Then concentrate on the heart. What's coming in the society, you know, like how things are coming in your life. As I said, everything has to be open to the stimulus. If you're not aware of the things around you, then this just becomes like a 1-hour exercise. So then anything is fine. You know, going, sitting down, closing your eyes is also fine.
Yeah, when you're getting like a lot of pressure and you want to get, you get upset, then it's a
breathing. So next person, you know, lower your breath, increase your breath. That you have to see. Now you know that this is calming you down. So lower your breath. Sometimes you're feeling, not feeling much good about yours. You want to do something, but you're not getting motivated. Just fasten your thing and see.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not feeling appetite, just increase your breath and see what is happening.
Mm-hmm.
If you're feeling too much hungry or not feeling, just lower and see if your hunger is going on. So that way with awareness you apply it, it will become beneficial.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the exercises. I think 4 exercises are, if you go on practicing it well, give a control over it. These exercises can go from like 10 minutes to 1 hour. You don't even have to do any asanas and all. Only thing, because you're sitting in siddhasana initially, you'll get this back stiffness. So just in between you can go down, stretch out. That's fine. And again come back and sit. As the spine becomes strong, you won't even require any. Your body will become so flexible that you can sit in there for hours and nothing happens.
Okay.
It all depends upon how much practice you put. Eventually you see the body will also start getting good structure, shape, unnecessary fat will start dissolving very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Body will also become tight, you know, sagginess will go.
Sagging.
Only thing is, yes, you'll have to eat on time and sleep on time because hormones need to work in tandem.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. It's not that you can eat anytime, sleep anytime. So if you do that very well, I think so, stay away from refined sugars and all, as I told you last time.
Mm-hmm.
So those things will definitely help you in the long run, more awareness will come. Eventually you can, once your control comes, you can see fast, slow, slow, fast, what is helping you, and make your own observations. It's a very self-sustained practice. The practice will only give you what stimulus you have in life. It's like what things you are doing, whom people you are meeting, what kind of work you are doing. So the practice develops accordingly. So it will be very difficult for me to tell what will happen. But these things will definitely, their sleep patterns will improve, appetite will be proper, you will feel good about yourself, digestion will be proper, allergies will go down, immunity will increase. Most times you can see a change in your vision also. Vision also improves with this most times. It won't change the number, but you can see that the things which you cannot read from a distance, mm-hmm. without specs, now you can able to read it because the brain power improves.
Uh-huh.
So a lot of things, memory will improve, bone patterns improve. These physical changes will get a lot of benefit within like 40 days if you do it very well. So start with 5 minutes a day. After every 5 minutes, increase it to 10, 15, 20. Then gradually increase your practice. So it can go as much time as you like. The breath practice as much time as you like. But always the rhythm should be there. You should not be hasted. If you don't feel like practice today, don't do it. It's not something you have to do every day. So if you get up today, you don't just feel like, you know, don't do anything. But once you do it well. A lot of people do it, have to do it every day, go to gym every day. It's not required. Don't do half job. If you can do only one practice today, fire breath, just do that. If you can only do slow breathing, just do that.